Southern Nevada man who's been trying to solve multiple mysteries surrounding his own identity says he's made a lot of progress in the 8 years since his quest began.
Now, the I-Team was first to report about the strange case of Paul Fronczak, who used a DNA test to confirm that he isn't the person that he always thought himself to be.
But what became of the real Paul Fronczak? George Knapp has the latest.
When I started this, everyone said, don't waste your time. Remember, they said, you won't find Paul. You won't find out who you are.
Nevadan Paul Fronczak began his seemingly improbable quest 8 years ago.
I'm going to do this.
That's when he first reached out to us after the results of DNA tests turned his world upside down. The tests confirmed he wasn't a Fronczak after all.
There's no remote possibility that you are the Fronczak baby. And I was like, wow.
The real Paul Fronczak had been kidnapped from a Chicago hospital in 1964, one day after his birth, snatched by a mystery woman dressed as a nurse. The crime sparked a nationwide search and worldwide headlines, but was never solved. 2 years later, a toddler found abandoned in New Jersey was shown to the still grieving parents, Dora and Chester Fronczak, who accepted the boy as their missing son, adopted him, and raised him in a loving home. As he grew older, though, Paul suspected something wasn't quite right. In 2012, he coaxed his parents into taking DNA tests. The results shocked them. Paul contacted us and vowed to find not only the kidnapped baby, but also his own biological family.
You've learned so much in those 8 years, but every road you go down, it leads to darker and darker questions.
Yeah, this whole journey has been one step forward, two steps back. You know, we get close to something and maybe someone dies the day we're supposed to meet.
Thousands of tips from the public have poured into Fronczak's websites. He wrote a book about his search, The Foundling. In 2018, in the small town of Manton, Michigan, news stories about the Fronczak mystery struck a chord with one family. The adult children of a Manton man took DNA tests of their own and came to the conclusion that their father was the real Paul Fronczak. They reached out to the Fronczak family in Chicago. The FBI was informed, and the word spread in their small community.
Hey, it's Paul in Vegas. How you doing?
Investigators working with Nevada's Paul Fronczak did their own legwork. DNA results were compared. All indications are the man in Manton was the baby kidnapped in 1964. In December 2019, the I-Team was first to report that the Fronczak baby was alive and living in Michigan. Our affiliate station, WGN in Chicago, followed our clues and found the man in Manton. He confirmed his identity to the reporters, but asked that his name be kept private. Now, in his first interview in more than a year, Nevada's Paul Fronczak says he is keeping a promise to biological Paul.
And I can't give his name out yet because it's not a good time. But I will say that my mom got to talk to him.
During our interview, we showed him a recent news article and photo of the man in Manton.
We didn't release the name, but I did see this a couple of weeks ago. It's an obituary notice with his name on it, and there's a photo. I don't know if you've seen that photo, but and you can't comment on whether that's him. But is there a family resemblance?
Definitely. Definitely a resemblance.
The photo in question was included in an obituary notice. The name of the deceased is Kevin Beatty, who was reportedly born in Michigan in 1964 and died of cancer earlier this year. From what we've learned, Kevin Beatty was the kidnapped infant, Paul Fronczak. The FBI in Chicago is aware of his identity, but declined to acknowledge it publicly, saying it has an ongoing investigation and is asking for privacy for the victims. Nevada's Paul Fronczak won't confirm the identity, except to say he's relieved that his long-suffering mom, Dora Fronczak, was able to speak with biological Paul earlier this year, shortly before Kevin Beatty died.
I've reached out to the real Paul and his children, and I sent the real Paul my book, and I heard from my tipsters that he read the book, he liked it, and he let his friends read it. But as far as communicating with me, nothing.
George Knapp, 8 News Now.
And by the way, Paul Fronczak found his birth family and learned that he has a twin sister, but she's missing and may have been murdered. We're going to have more on that story tomorrow. We do have links to additional information on our website at 8newsnow.com.